the former one lightweight world champion, Shinya Aoki, the former Shooto and Dream lightweight champion. What makes Aoki so damn good in the grapple?
It's that clinch. He's so dominant inside the clinch, and you never know what he's going to do when he gets there.
The reincarnation, the reimagining, the revolution of Shinya Aoki is almost complete. A dast choke finish for Aoki. Still on top of the martial arts world after so long. Another first round finish. What a resurgence. 44 wins for the man who began martial arts in judo as a 10-year-old. Aoki is just so, so good.
That's Mel Tan.
Judge.
That's Koji Ando.
Ready?
And fight. That's Shinya Aoki. This for the one lightweight championship. This fight brought to you by G-Shock. Absolute toughness.
Shinya immediately shoots in for the takedown, wanting to get this fight as quickly as he can to the ground.
Absolutely as sharp as attack, isn't he?
Nice little front push kick there. Shinya wants to showcase, I believe he wants to showcase his newly improved stand-up game.
Right hand from Shinya before he clutched those thighs.
But he knows that standing with Koji Ando is a dangerous game to play.
Look at the difference in torso, Mitch.
Yeah, these guys look like they're fighting in different weight classes. Ando is a gigantic lightweight. And Shinya should, very well could possibly drop to 145, the featherweight division.
Well, he has already in the ONE Championship cage once, successfully so as well. Is his strength deceptive?
Yeah, he is incredibly strong. In that judo, takedowns can come from anywhere. But this, see how the judo game is kind of nullified because they're both black belts in judo. But Shinya likes to incorporate other types of takedowns. You know, he likes to borrow from other martial arts that he can bring into this game. And working with the world champions at Evolve, he also has that wrestling pedigree as well.
At the moment, Ando pinned up against the cage. Aoki adjusts his height from grasping the waist up towards the shoulders. He gets his head caught there in the right arm of Ando. Two Japanese fighters getting it on in Singapore.
Shinya finally able to get Koji Ando to the ground. Let's see what can happen here as Shinya advances his position. Koji has to be trying to get back up to his feet, but he's just kind of holding the head there. He should be pushing away, working his way up the wall. See how he sucks him away from the wall?
It's crazy. There's a hush around this entire indoor stadium, which is packed to the rafters. And this is the fight, really, that they've all been waiting for. But they're all just enthralled by this duel.
Well, this is what everybody expected. Shinya take him to the ground, advance his position, and work for a spectacular finish.
How he got out of that, I'm not quite sure. It was almost like a conjuring trick.
See, that's his strength. He was able to rip the hand off his head like that. So he's using the head position right there. He's slowly trying to work his way up. Koji Ando is doing a decent way, kind of keeping that butterfly guard on the one side. Kind of prevents him from advancing his position. See how he keeps his knee high? Now he's locked into half guard.
With the right elbow on and around the throat there.
See, that's the strength of Shinya Aoki. He can just control that hand just like that. And there's nothing Koji Ando can do.
With his left arm there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He just has it pinned to his side. And there's nothing he can do. Coach has got to try to get off his back. See, now he's trying to inch him to the side so he can move up. I see Coach trying to initiate a scramble so he can get moving. But she is deceptively strong.
Very deliberate, isn't it? Suddenly the blows come in, forearm chops to the throat.
He knows exactly how to use his weight, exactly where to position to keep maximum pressure on you.
He's going for the jaw, not the throat.
No holding.
Elbow there as well.
Referee Olivier Koss trying to urge the action.
There's a degree of stalemate here. You wonder what Olivier will do, how much longer he'll allow this.
But that's part of Shinya's game. He tries to advance the position slowly and methodically moving forward.
For sure, Shinya wouldn't be happy if he got stood up.
We've got a minute left in this first champ round of this 5-round title fight.
Let's go, guys, work!
So Olivier Coste asking them to work. That's quite a way from standing them up. And in fact, we've advanced to a position where that's not necessary anymore.
But Koji Ando is doing a good job of defending and kind of stopping the advanced ground game of Shinya Aoki.
Well, he looks very calm under pressure, doesn't he? He's just nodding to instructions from his corner.
He's not freaking out. He's very composed, very relaxed. He knew this was probably going to happen. He prepared for it extensively.
Yeah, if there was one thing you could predict about a fight with Shinya, it was this kind of thing was going to happen.
Yeah, he probably spent a long, many, many hours preparing his ground game for this.
Elbows to the head from Shinya in the final 10 seconds of the opening round.
Koji's finally able to stand up, but that little too late.
So, pretty much all of the action on the mat. One movement, very carefully, cautiously, advancing from A to B to C. A little bit of stalemate. These guys very, very well matched. Rich, easy to score that round or pretty difficult?
No, I thought it was easy to score. Even though Shinya was in control the whole time, it's still a very, very close fight. He's ahead on the aggression category, and I gave him points on the aggression because he was able to actually, like, press his game plan and unfold it, and then that led to the takedown that he had scored. I didn't actually score him in the ground control category necessarily, but I have some kind of mental notes and tick marks, as well as some tick marks in the damage inflicted because he started landing some strikes there. Just hasn't really done enough to score in those higher categories yet, so this really still is a close fight.
And impressed, Mitch, aren't we, with the fact that Ando didn't collapse under pressure. He seemed very cool and calm. As you say, he expected this. What wouldn't you expect? From Shinya Aoki in that kind of situation. He knew what was coming, seemed to take it all in his stride.
Let's see if he changes his game plan up here and tries to stay away as far away from the clinch as possible and use that advanced boxing that he has.
I've remarked upon it before, but just look at the difference in size of upper body. It's amazing that Shinya seems to be able to control the grappling side of the game when you look at the two torsos. But that's where skill, experience, timing, and just sometimes pure unorthodoxness comes.
Yeah, Shinya's getting very close to not having to cut any weight to make the lightweight limit. So, I mean, I think he's actually preparing slowly for more, you know, possible super fights in the featherweight division.
I wonder if Bibiano Fernandez would come up from bantamweight to featherweight. He's told me he would. There's a super fight in the offing.
I didn't want to spoil that, but
we'll leave that for another day.
Ando was a little timid. Look at Shinya throwing a head kick. Nice.
Definitely connected on that ear. Koji Ando's left ear just turned a little bit redder. And then takes a kick to the midriff as well.
Shinya, look at him smiling a little bit there.
Yeah.
He's like, I'm feeling this.
I don't know. Is that a smile?
I'm never
quite sure how to read Shinya. Nice little right hand from that, from a southpaw stance. And another one just knocks Shinya's head back a little.
I think Koji's a little bit timid to really kind of push the striking because he's scared of the takedown and ended up on his back for another 3 minutes. Shinya throwing kicks very comfortably. It's nice when you're that confident with your ground game because you can, you know, you usually explore more options with your stand-up. Where Shinya typically wouldn't be able to do this. He's okay with being put on his back.
Okay. All right, fight!
Mutual respect shown. A good sportsmanship there.
Greeted by appreciative applause. Oh, swinging right hand did not connect from Koji Ando.
Shinya added a nice little left-hand counter there. I like to see Shinya set up that those kicks a little bit, with some hands. Get Ando to expose himself.
At the moment, it's the right jab of Koji Ando and the right leg of Shinya Aoki where we're seeing attacks.
Both these fighters look a little bit timid. They're just kind of moving back and forward. They're not really having any lateral movement. Shinya's backing up a bit. I don't think he's liking that jab very much. It's starting to open up a little bit.
And Aoki's nose is getting a little reddened. No big surprise. It's a good, solid jab. It's a quick one as well.
Ando's just trying to find his range with that jab. He's not really putting any combinations together. You think at this point, at the 8-minute mark of this fight, this five-round title fight, there'd be a little bit more urgency, so to speak. But we do have, you know, a long time left in this title fight.
Shinya Aoki is well capable of taking an opponent down. He doesn't seem to be attempting that in this round, though, Mitch.
Yeah, he's definitely wanted to. I knew he wanted to showcase an evolved element of his stand-up, no pun intended. It's definitely, you know, it's very evenly matched stand-up exchange.
He's getting a bit of an exhibition of right jabs from Ando, and that nose is looking quite damaged from Shinya. It's red. There may be a bit of a cut on there as well, at least a graze.
1 minute.
Yeah. Keep taking those all night. These are 25 minutes of fighting.
The damage inflicted definitely has to go to Koji Ando in this second round here. But again, fights are judged on a whole.
Fascinating to get Rich's take on this. A completely different second 5 minutes from the first set that we saw.
Shinya hasn't even attempted to close the distance and initiate a takedown. And Ando's just picking him apart with that right jab, like you keep saying.
He's got to be pretty pleased with this round, Koji Ando.
He has to be building his confidence.
We're not talking about one round each, remember. The whole fight is judged in its entirety. So it's the quality of the work you do in any one period of time.
Ando's actually quite smart because he's throwing zero leg kicks with a possibility for Aoki to catch it and take him down. It's all hands.
Well, this has been a five-minute period where Koji Ando has got himself back into this fight after taking the first round in his stride very, very well indeed. What on earth are we going to see in this next 5 minutes?
I definitely think Shinya is going to alter his game plan.
He has to, doesn't he? Because if he keeps going on like that, he could end up losing the fight just being out-jabbed.
See that he attempted, he thought about the takedown, he initiated it. He didn't quite attempt it, but he did threaten it.
Already looking for it in the first 10 seconds, but that jab has presented itself again. And they're
four
on the button, aren't they?
Yeah,
Shinya's
they
guard.
Very accurate.
Isn't low, but it's not stopping those punches coming through. There's the takedown.
Completely changed the game plan. Tried something new, got to give him credit for that, but he's going back to his bread and butter. And we're expecting probably to see Koji. Koji's got to initiate a scramble. He's got to move. He's got to try to work his way up that wall. And Shinya's just slowly pulling his hips away from that cage so he can't walk his way up.
So he lets go of the neck. Ando, what's next on his plan?
Ando's got to push away, and he's got to try to work his way up. But Aoki's going to slowly inch him away from that wall so he can't get there. I know because I have been on the receiving end of this technique numerous times. It is classic Aoki. Ando's, he's kind of defending well, but he's not really trying to escape or initiate a scramble to really kind of move out of the position. He's holding onto the half guard, but even Aoki's not even trying to pass the half guard very effectively. And he's content to just hold him there. I think Olivia Cost in this deep in the round is probably going to initiate a stand-up unless Aoki's delivering some substantial damage.
Watch out, headbutt, watch out, headbutt, watch out. Watch out.
Olivia Cost warning the fighters not to butt heads.
See, Ando's just kind of holding on and stalling for time, which is actually a good technique.
I'm stunned by this crowd. They've been noisy all evening, but there's no booze of dissatisfaction here. They are just enthralled.
I think this educated crowd we have here in Singapore is just waiting for something spectacular to happen, like out of thin air from Shinya to finish this fight.
They know their stuff here, right up and down Asia, wherever we go. It seems everybody knows mixed martial arts. a sport that is growing at quite a pace, particularly in this part of the world.
Into full mount now. Now this is a very dangerous position for Koji Ando. He has got to try to move and push off the cage, create some kind of movement, but he's just stalling there.
He's got his feet firmly on that cage, so there's something he can work with.
All he can really do is spin himself around in a corner. He's not close enough to push off the cage and rotate out of it. He's better off putting his feet on the floor and trying to buck his hips up to create some space from Shinya, but that's so much easier said than done.
Because of the way Ando's head was oriented, Shinya put a few punches into the back of the head. He was warned by the referee about that. Now, forearm and elbow to the face.
See, but even in the scrambles, that's when Shinya can catch you with some incredible submissions. So this is actually an interesting strategy on Koji's part to just kind of wait it out. He's so heavy in that position. He like doubles his weight the better the position gets on for Aoki.
He'll need to be a bucking bronco here to get rid of his compatriot.
I don't know why Koji's crossing the leg like that. He's got to try to create some space and move. He's actually defending the strikes pretty well.
Ando taking elbows though, and I think I'm seeing blood there. Yeah, I am seeing blood. It's elbows and forearms.
Might be the bridge of the
nose. I think it's the bridge of the nose. Which shows how central Aoki's striking has been from that position.
You can see just how much more dominant Aoki is in the ground game. Ando may be he's definitely a black belt in judo, but the ground game is just so far superior in Aoki's favor.
It's like we've seen three entirely different rounds. There's really no consistency. Oh, now, here we go.
An attempted armbar here. He's hooking the leg. He's got 30 seconds. Can Ando hold on? This very well could be it. The strikes have softened him up. Oh, he's got to keep those arms clasped together. If he can keep those hands clasped.
20 seconds.
Uh-oh, he's slowly working. He's got to keep it tight.
He's still holding onto his own hand. He'll have to do that. For all he's worth, I think Shinya's given up on it. Or just about 10 seconds left. Doesn't look as if he's really pursuing it.
He's got to use all that upper body strength to maintain the position.
To separate the hands, but he's holding on for grim death. And in the process, right at the bell there, took another sharp elbow to the forehead. And I rather think that Koji Ando's nose is a bit of a mess at the moment. And that corner will have to work on it.
Ando definitely showing some advanced boxing with that right jab, just kind of bloodying up Shinya a bit.
Yeah,
but
Shinya's cut too, actually. I think also in a similar sort of place, they're working on the nose. Rich, how are we seeing this now after three very different rounds?
I have Aoki ahead at the 15-minute point of this fight. Landed a takedown there, and then he followed up. He's using his game plan well. He moves from the aggressive category to his takedowns to the ground control category. He was able to control the ground and actually land some damage and get further ahead in that category as well. So Aoki ran away with it the last 5 minutes.
So a seesaw contest, the latter part of this fight thus far, is Aoki's. 10 minutes left.
Ready?
And you figure that Koji Ando will want to keep this one standing up, given what's gone before. That's where his success has come, and it's all been from the right jab. And Aoki has not been successful in parrying it away. That jab is quick and strong enough to get through that guard, that open hand guard that Aoki has, and it's landed on that nose repeatedly. Therefore, Aoki goes for the takedown.
See how he gets a hold of that single leg and then just sucks it in.
Just pulls it in.
This is deja vu.
Ando almost had a look of resignation about him there, if I was reading him correctly. Not again, I think he was saying. I stayed on my feet for 30 seconds. Now I've got 4.5 minutes to deal with this.
Yeah, I think it's going to be the exact same thing. Shinya's going to try to slowly inch those hips away from the cage so Ando's unable to get up and then work into a more dominant position. Yep, slowly pulling him away, advancing his position. High level grappling from our world champion.
Is there a signature finish that this world champion likes to pull towards, or can it come from anywhere?
In a lot of his past fights, he's been using some very unorthodox type submissions, neck cranks, twisters, rear naked chokes. He's definitely sort of evolved his ground game. You have nowhere he's going to actually go to.
He likes to come up with something new and original, doesn't
exactly.
he?
You know, you never know what he's going to do. So it's just an absolute, that's why I believe the crowd is so quiet right now, is because they're just, they're anticipating something amazing coming from anywhere.
I'm just looking over your shoulder and everyone's completely drawn to the cage, mouths open, many of them. There aren't many blinks going on at the moment.
See, now Ando, he's kind of given up the half guard. Now he's got full mount going on. This is a dangerous position. Now he's given his back up. Now this could be a face crank. She's finished a lot of opponents with an uncomfortable face crank. If he can't get the choke, he comes across the chin with his forearm, creating tremendous pressure on the neck and the face.
That look of resignation we saw after 30 seconds of this round from Ando, he's really up against it now. He's had some success. That second five-minute period was a good one for him. But that's what he needs more of. This is not where he wants to be, not with Shinya Aoki on his back.
Yeah, I think this is a nightmare for most mixed martial artists in any division, having a grappler the caliber of Aoki on your back, and you're unable to defend it. He's still got 2 minutes left in this round to do work. Now he's body triangled him. That is so uncomfortable. The pressure that puts on the rib cage, it makes it hard to breathe. And you've been fighting so far for 18 minutes.
2 minutes left of the fourth round. This one, a five-round contest, 25 minutes in all. The lightweight championship belt is on the line. It currently belongs to Shinya Aoki, his compatriot, doing all he can to rid him of it, but it's proving an uphill struggle.
It's a good defensive strategy that Ando has. He's kind of answering the phone with the one side, which prevents Aoki from getting in on that side, and he's holding the glove on his left hand, so he can't attack him there either. So his defensive strategy is actually quite impressive.
All the while, Shinya's busy, isn't he, with that right hand, going body, head, body, head.
Yeah, he's just pounding on him now. He's probably going to survive this round, though, so you got to give Ando a lot of credit for surviving on the ground for so much time with possibly the world's best grappler.
1 minute left of the fourth round.
Let's
go, guys, work.
Olivier Coste asking for work, which seems harsh, doesn't it? But
yeah, they're working, and they've been working. And this is the title fight. This crowd wants some action. He wants some action. We've had a night filled with some amazing mixed martial arts ups and downs, explosive knockouts, incredible submissions.
It's the style of the fight and the style of the fighters. The crowd appreciate that.
But this fight is so technical, as Rich said. So many small little intricate things are happening at every single moment. We got 20 seconds.
20 seconds. I imagine that Rich is going to tell us that Shinya has moved further ahead. And with 5 minutes left now, Koji Ando really has to get this fifth round on the feet and do something explosive with those fists, more than just the jabs that he's had success with. He's got to unload with the big left hand as well, because that's about the only option he's got. Am I right, Rich Franklin?
Yeah, listen, this was all Shinya Aoki. He's running away with this. He earned another takedown, has some more ground control there. So. Not a surprise probably to the fans watching. This is all Aoki at this point in time.
Koji Ando is running out of options, but his strategy, it seems, is clear. He needs to keep this fight standing up.
Ready?
He needs to unload with that successful right jab of his, and then he needs to step it up some more.
I do believe that Koji Ando's only shot at taking away the lightweight title is to knock out Aoki in the final round here in this world title fight, because Aoki is running away with scoring, as Rich said. Ando looking to set up that jab, but needs a lot more than a jab to knock out a fighter the caliber of Aoki.
Leaning forward from the waist, mouth open. Ando, a picture of concentration and pursuit. It's he who's coming forward. That's no surprise. He has to chase this contest now. Aoki a little bit more relaxed, can afford to be defensive in the stand-up and take whatever opportunities come for the takedown.
He has a very high success rate on most of his takedowns, because even if he misses the takedown, he grabs onto a limb and kind of works his way up into the clinch and then manages to take him down.
And that's the thing in the stand-up as well. Ando knows he can't commit too much, perhaps with a big left hand, because throwing a limb in there is like throwing it into a nest of vipers. Aoki can twist and turn and ruin you in a night.
Ando going back to that bread and butter right jab of his, which has been his most dominant weapon so far tonight.
Oh, tremendous kick to the chops there. And sweat and water flew off Ando's head.
Ando stalking forward. Oh, he jumps guard. That's an very interesting takedown that Aoki chose to. He jumped into the flying guard.
Have we got a name for that takedown?
That is a very risky attempt right there.
And then a heel in the face, followed up by a right hand in the face. Less than 3 minutes now. Koji Ando on his knees, quite literally as well as figuratively, because he's got a lot to do.
Don't grab the gloves.
Don't grab the gloves, Olivier Coste is saying. Shinya Aoki using both hands to grab Koji Ando's glove. Is that an illegal move, Rich?
It's not illegal to actually grab the glove, but what it would be illegal to do is weave your fingers underneath the glove. But you can actually grab around the glove, use the wrist and all that kind of stuff.
Okay. 2.25 minutes left. Ando dabs at his eye with his right hand. He's far from desperate, but he knows he needs to do something. You don't see desperation in that body language, but he's pursuing Aoki because he knows he needs to push the pace. He must dictate these final 2 minutes, and far more than that, he needs to be explosive, looking for an opening.
And it can happen. He has won by knockout in the past. But at this stage of the fight, Aoki is just way too far ahead, moving away.
Backing off, circling, a little skip here and there. Takes a right hand, a right hook to the jaw. But he's got a good chin, Shinya. He can take punches like that for a while. A couple of decent jabs again from Ando. That's been his best work of the night, but it's not nearly enough, not at this stage. With a minute and a quarter left, Shinya looked to take it to the ground and just ride out this contest. But they're still on the feet, and while they are, Ando still has a chance. That's something similar to what we saw before. And Shinya chases him on his butt. He gets pulled up by Olivier Coste, or beckoned up, I should say. Have you ever seen a fighter chase another on his butt, Mitch?
I actually have seen that before. But that's actually a very dangerous maneuver to execute, because we do have the technical ground kick. There's that right jab again, snapping the head of Aoki back.
Whoa, there's all sorts going on. Shinya's still on his butt, and he's again, he's pursuing Ando, and this works for him, and he's sticking his tongue out, and he's doing push-ups, and he's taunting Ando now.
Showman is coming out in Aoki. He senses it.
As he circles the cage, knowing that he can stay out of range. Oh, my goodness. Again, on his backside, he leant out of range. And really, he's just having fun with Ando now. Shinya Aoki finishes this fight in complete and utter control. It's inconceivable that when the announcement is made, that belt won't go round Aoki's waist. He's applauding the crowd and his fans onto the rim of the cage, thanking his supporters. Seems inevitable that he'll be awarded that belt again, another defense of his lightweight title. And just above us, Koji Ando wanders around with his hand on his hips thinking, well, what else could I have done? Are there any answers to defeating this man?
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all three judges, see it for your winner. And still, one lightweight world champion, Shinya Tobikan Judan Aoki!
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.